Hello, I'm Fred Miller, and this is a very brief description of one of my hour-long lectures in song. When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore. Well, I ain't talking and singing about some great personality or significant aspect of American popular song. This time, Cantare, the Italian presence in American popular song. America's melting pot is glorious. 1,001 ethnicities, backgrounds, and talents. American popular song owes a special debt to the descendants of Neapolitans, Romans, Venetians, Florentines, Milanese, Calabrians, Sicilians, and the countless little villages scattered throughout that colorful, boot-shaped land of sea, sun, soil, and song. Before DiMaggio, before LaGuardia, even before Sinatra, the first 20th century Italian-American superstar was Enrico Caruso. His renown coincides with the arrival of the earliest recorded mass media, allowing his legendary tenor voice to reach far beyond the stage of the Metropolitan Opera. American popular song would come of age with the addition of the microphone, radio, and the talkies, and poised at the center of that garden of delights were Italians. Composers Harry Warren and Henry Mancini, singers Russ Colombo, Louis Prima, Perry Como, Vic Damone, Mario Lanza, Frankie Lane, Al Martino, Tony Bennett, Dean Martin, and of course, Frank Sinatra. The red, white, and green banner continued to wave prominently as rock displaced pop in the mainstream. Bobby Darin, Connie Francis, Dion and the Belmonts, Frankie Valli and the Four Seasons. Cantare is to sing, and sing the Italians have throughout the golden age of American popular song. Clearly, bel canto is not merely the province of grand opera, but essential to any great singing. Capisce? To engage me for this or any other lecture in song, please visit FredMillerMusic.com for where you can contact me and review the entire series of more than 70 different lectures in song. Thanks for watching and look forward to hearing from you.